Okay, so here's the radio for the Volkswagen. It's about the same thickness as stock. Okay, here's the Beetle radio kit. It's pretty light. It's actually lighter than the stock one, but it doesn't have all that reinforcement in there. It just has the brackets that are screwed on there, which I have to look into that because the brackets that are on it have the cover for the vents. So sure how that's gonna work. It's got the button covers right there if you do not have an 06 or whatever, which are these, and they do not fit. So if you try to put them in, hold on, I gotta pause it. Okay, so here it is put in, but it doesn't go all the way in. And it's supposed to sit in there, but there's nowhere for it to sit. Now that's the hazard button. Now the airbag one, probably same scenario. Yeah, same scenario. So your best bet for that is to switch to the upper airbag or airbag light and the hazard switch. Now, find one for you. I had one sitting right here. Here we go. Apparently not. Anyway, the airbag switch for that, the plug is exactly the same as the one that is push button down here. The wires are shorter. And if you get it from a junkyard, there is an adapter that plugs into the harness that runs down to that switch. But the other end of the adapter looks like this. This is part of the car. So I cut this out of the car because everything else is plug and play. So you're going to have to get male adapters and put them all on this. And then you'll be able to plug that end with these adapters into the harness that goes to the switch, which mine is in a car apparently. Okay, the one that I ordered did not have the radio, because I ordered a radio. It did come with a harness that plugged into the radio that I got, which I already had mine built. Probably use mine. This dimmer wire is hooked up, mine is not. So I'll try both to see how it is, but I like that my harness is longer. Came with trim removal tools that you're not going to use. The brackets to adapt down here for the dash. These are here to hold your vents inside. And this little miscellaneous screws. The radio itself, the back of it looks like this. And you know, you have your harness for your backup cameras or your audio video cables and everything else. Now this is a 9-inch. Even though the radio is advertised, or the dash is advertised as a 10-inch, the 9-inch fits all the way down in there. So, looking at the pictures, I thought it would stop at that little groove and then you can add a 10-inch around it, but apparently it does not. It goes all the way through. Okay, so this right here is the Jetta HVAC climate focus. Now they fit in. It just has a littler, has a gap. It sits down, it's recessed. But I have the Jetta control knobs that fit in here that I'm putting in. So they fit in. These are the Beetle ones, which obviously fit. They got a little bit of rock to them and they sit flush. So you got a little bit of wiggle play for those, which is a plus, because I was putting the Jetta ones in and I literally went and filed all these down to make it so they would fit in. And that was pointless. Waste of some time to build those. So I am going to be adapting the Jetta, the MK4. Actually, I think this was out of Passat. But to fit in there so I can use my climate control knobs that I ordered for the MK4 Jetta. So when you remove your vents, they will look like this on the two corners. Shit. And then this corner will look like that. You're gonna have to break that little tab off so it looks like this. So all four corners look like that because this goes over top of it and bolts it into there. And if you don't break that tab off, then the screws won't fit through. Now, here is the hazards switch, this part plugs into the hazard lights, and your hazard light switch in your car is like this. It's like it would reach if you didn't have to pull the radio out, like push all the way in. So you can get this harness adapter. This is for the airbag light, which mine's not going to use for the passenger airbag light because it's a 2000. But the other end that plugs into the car is this end, which this came from the car. So what I have to do is put the male splicers onto this. That way I can plug this into here and then that end to the plug that looks like this in the car, just to convert it so it's longer. And then there's the HVAC control. I guess. Let's see how well it fits, if it fits. Okay, I would have to say the passenger switch fits in really well. The hazard is a little loose fitting. It works, but it kind of feels like it would pop out. this is how, or what I was talking about, the tabs. You see, you slide this piece over, and the tab goes through the holes like this. It does not go through this hole up here. The little tab part that is right there is blocking it, so that's why you have to cut it off. Then you mount them in through this way, and the lighting sucks. Okay, this is what it looks like after you install the vents. Going to continue to do so with all the other parts. Still some pieces over there. Got to do the climate control, and I'll get back. Okay, I got the wire. I lost it right here. This is for the hazard lights. I got it wired in. It's the same colors, so you don't have to worry about which pin you're going into. Just, well, you do, but it's the same color from this connector to the old connector. Now my other concern was this, because the inside of this radio over here does not have it. This right here is what comes in your radio, factory one, and it sits right here and it mounts down like that, and it presses those little foam all the way around that. That way your defroster comes through here into this hole and then spreads out over there to both sides of that. So if you do not cover that hole, your defrost is going to go into the dash area, because this kit, my car is a huge mess, does not have that. It's just flat. So I cut this down from one of the 6 or 7 I have in the garage. And I'm going to have to file it a little bit more because it doesn't fit under this. So cut it here just to keep this bottom piece there. And then I have HVAC tape because I'm HVAC certified. So I'll do that up there, kind of like this right here, because this right here was the blend door fix. So it's going to be the same concept up there. Just have to remove the foam and cut that plastic out and put it up there, because if you just put tape over it, it's just going to get sticky over time and come off, and that's not going to be very good for you. So I'll get that done, and then I'll turn this back on. Okay, sorry these bounce around, but the only way to continuously do it while recording is to just hit pause, but when you get a text message or anything else, it cancels out your video, so then you gotta start over anyway, so I just stopped the video. Anyway, here's a little piece that I cut. It sits right here in between those little spots. You can see the grooves. So that will sit down there like this, and then you tape that into here. So then my HVAC vents are in. This right here is the Jetta one. Here's the Volkswagen one. You can see that the Volkswagen's deeper. So the mounting points on this had to change. I cut them off and moved them back. You can see, and then I just used rivets and put them into place. I'm not positive, but I think the Jetta one is recessed like this. The plugs are all the same and all that stuff, so if that's the case, you can just use the whole Jetta one. I'll try to confirm that later, but so yeah, these knobs were from Amazon for the MK4. The black bezel piece is from a Jetta or a Passat. I can't remember which one I got it out of. And then you also need this clear piece right here for the same. because this one's deeper and does not fit inside this. So then there are little tabs right there, you can see, and then there is a black tab that goes right here. It's not gonna focus. But that tab has to be broken off because it does not push in. But if you push this in to lock it, the tab will break itself off and go flying towards your face. So be careful with that. Now, if you do use the Jetta one, you are going to have to pull your buttons off for the Volkswagen, for the Beetle, because the Jetta ones are square at the ends. So they would look kind of, well, they wouldn't fit in this at all because it's rounded. So you just pull them off and they just push back in. It's pretty easy. Now to remove your knobs, you're gonna set them all straight up and down and then they just pull straight out. The hardest one is this one. But your knobs, you're not going to be using them anyway. Here's the Beetle one. So I just grabbed them with a pair of pliers and pulled it out and it was fine. So I'm going to put this on. You can see it fits pretty good. And then start mounting everything up and then I'll come back. Okay, that's taped up. The harness is here. If you're planning on not pulling the radio back out, but you didn't add your steering wheel controls and stuff, you should just tap into your wires, run them, and at the ends of your wire, cut them off. That way, when you do run the wires, you know what they are. Zip tie everything back up, heat shrink everything. This is the back of the radio. Everything's in here, all zip tied. All the wires are heat shrunk. It's a good idea to add the amplified antenna adapter. That way you get better reception. Don't forget to plug in your GPS, which is all over there. Zip tie these up out of the way to this. Otherwise, they're going to go into your gears and you're going to have issues with your climate control. This runs over into the dash. And the wire for the hazard lights now runs along the side and out the bottom here. And there's the plug. And there was a mosquito. Okay, so all my wiring's out here. Here's all my USBs, the backup camera, some auxiliary cables. Because it does have auxiliary, I just ran this one into it. And then I will get the converter from female to female and run. I don't have one sitting here to show you. Yeah, like this. So then you can take this plug and get you one of these spares and you can cut it out and this goes below your radio to where your old hazard switch would be. That way it's a little easier. I have two blanks down there now, so the other one will be two USBs, which are these. So I will get the adapter that are just side by sides where you can cut out and put it into a filler panel and then just mail to mail and hook that back up that way. So here's a huge mess that's going on. I'm going to install this and then I'll turn the radio back on or turn the video back on. Okay, so this little bracket on this side, where your blend door and everything is, was hitting this. You see it's close now, so I had to break this tab off. So now it spins, so now put it all back together again and see if it works. Okay, after you get it mounted, you're going to have to take these off of your old one for right here and the two on the bottom side, and I had to move my defrost over to here from over here because the cables were way too short. Also scratched my dash, so not too thrilled about. But here's what it looks like. It's okay. It takes an extremely long time to do it. You know, the Volkswagens are small, and I'm 6'5", so trying to maneuver around and do cartwheels in this thing and get your hands in places it's not supposed to be, and you cut your fingers all up and everything else, so you just gotta watch out for that. One of the hardest parts is after you mount the climate control to get it back in and install the wires on it, the cables that open your blend doors and everything. And then the wiring for that is also short because it's used to being up here. So you have to pull on those. So the dash has to pretty much be all the way back, which leaves you like a couple inches on the side over here to get your hand into. And that just makes it a pain in the butt. Also, I did not film it because it's 90 degrees outside and I'm in the car with the tot, but there are two brackets that come with it. They mount to the holes on your dash where those holes used to go, and it's a L bracket, and then there's a screw that runs up this way. It comes with two black Phillips screws. You use those and then it mounts it. I guess there's still two holes down there where you're supposed to drill into your console, but I'm not doing that. It's kind of pointless. I mean, it's mounted with those two screws, the two that mounts into the dash, the two on the top. So it's fine. But you just got to put your little clips in here. That way you can push this back in. I still have to do it to the back ones. But that gives you little to no space for that cubby hole under there. Which really sucks because I can't reach the outlet for the charger. And I have the pocket cover there, the rubber mat for all my change and stuff. But I also have the two cup holders that sit inside there that lock in. And now I'm not sure if I can get my change and stuff out of it, because typically I keep quarters in one, dimes in the other, etc. Because there are two cup holders here and one back there. So after I get everything installed, I will turn the video back on. Okay, my neighbor's dog is barking, but here it is installed. Forgot to do that light, so it's that color. You need to turn the lights off. They go off. This is the interface. It has a lot of things I have to start up. So here's YouTube. So it's okay, I guess. But that's it. Okay, so here's the car. Here's how it looks installed. As you know, there's no lights in this thing. So yeah, pretty horrible lighting.